This is going to be a full test of my Potter PFC-4410 fire panel. The only trouble left on here is the battery, now that I have resistors on all the circuits. I have a bunch of devices connected to this thing. I've got DAT-AS, got DAT-Hochiki, SLK-24F smoke detector. I've got a Therm-L-Matic DI-135 spot type heat detector. That's fixed temp, 135 degrees. And I've got my Simplex 2099 9101 pull station. The other thing I have hooked up to this is, I have a Simplex 4080 wired up as a trouble bell. So if I were to cause an open circuit, this thing will ring. Okay, so I'll demonstrate that now by pulling the smoke detector off the base. Silence that trouble. I'm going to put it back. So now the only trouble again is the battery. So for our first alarm, I think we'll start with the smoke detector. I'm going to spray some artificial smoke right here. And it should go in. Oh, there it is. Silence that, blow it out. As you can see, the detector is still an alarm, so what we have to do is reset the system. That dropped power to the detector. And now our next device will be the pulse station. It would be hard to reset this with one hand. Let me grab my Simplex B key. All right, activate. Reset in progress. Reset complete. So now, the last device is this heat detector. Oh, shoot. Trouble silence. It's the battery trouble. Last device is this heat detector. Now, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure this is restorable, but some of the older ones aren't. And the newer ones, too. Some of the newer ones, they're kind of like honeybees. One sting and then they're dead. So we're going to turn on this hair dryer, let it warm up nice, and once it gets really hot, I tripped it. Now here's the real test. Once it cools off, will it be restored? And yes, it is a restorable heat detector. So I can use this again and again. It is a bumblebee, not a honeybee. That concludes the test of the Potter PFC-4410. Thanks for watching, everyone.